So, the uncontrolled rise in the price of general goods is known as inflation. But how this inflation generally occur in economy, it is something important to know at this point. And two other things I will discuss with you. Number one is the fiscal deficit and the deficit financing. And my dear friends, the deficit financing is one of the major cause for the inflation. How? See, this is fiscal deficit means the deficit related to the budget. We have the government budget. In the government budget, there is a systematic statement of the inflows of funds and outflows of funds, or the receipts and the expenditures. There are many ways for the inflow of funds or receipts. There are tax receipts, there are non-tax receipts, like then also in the taxes there are indirect tax like income tax, there are indirect tax like GST, custom duty like that, and there are direct tax like wealth tax, income tax, corporate tax, etc. So there are then other, the PSU also earns for the government, and there are ways also for the outflow of money which have been known as the government's expenditures. Like some of the expenditures of that kind, that they are expenditure but they does not give the repayments or returns instantly, because mainly the government spends the money on the social welfare like education, like infrastructure, like health related services, like government law and order, defense also. So they do not give the returns instantly. So such type of expenditures are there. So deficit, this budget deficit or fiscal deficit arises when the total expenditure exceeds the total receipts. So now what is done to overcome this fiscal deficit? There is a term in the economics that is known as the deficit financing. In the deficit financing, the government approach to the Reserve Bank or the Central Bank of the country, here we have the Reserve Bank of India, RBI, the government approach to the Reserve Bank for printing new currency. So when the in the deficit financing, when the RBI or the Central Bank of India prints the new currency and give it to the government, there is more money supply in the market. So this more money supply in the economic circulation on the market, it increases the purchasing power of the people. And when the people have money along with the purchasing power, they are ready to purchase or buy the goods and service even at the high prices. That is the main reason or cause of the inflation. So this fiscal deficit, then deficit financing to cover the fiscal deficit, and the circulation of more currency or more money in the economic circulation is one of the reason for the inflation. Okay, so you need to keep this thing in your mind. Now these were the background of the studies in the late 1980s which led to adopt the new policy reforms or new economic policy of 1991, which are generally known as the reforms of liberalization, privatization and globalization. Now this question arises, what were the needs, what were the requirement to adopt new economic policy or policy reforms of LPG in 1991. Here we have discussed the background, what were the economic circumstances, economic status of India at that time. Now this in the blue pen I have written here, what were the main needs or requirements. So we have to adopt the economic reforms or new economic policy of 1991. Number one, to improve the economic condition of India through borrowing from IMF and World Bank. See, at that time we were in the severe financial crisis. We had very adverse balance of payment. We have a very few foreign currency to import the goods, not more than for 1 month. That was the low level of the foreign currency, foreign exchange with us. So to improve the economic condition of India through borrowing IMF and World Bank, it was the main solution to borrow the loans from the foreign countries or from the international financial institutions like World Bank and Indian Monetary, International Monetary Firm, that is known as IMF. To maintain sufficient foreign exchange reserves, it is very, very important and crucial for any country, because we are now in the era of the globalization. So we have always this sufficient amount or sufficient reserve of the foreign currency or foreign exchange. To check the inflation, uncontrolled rise in the general goods. It was one of the problem that has led to adopting the new economic policies of 1991. To make our economy more competitive and efficient to face global market. See, that was the era of the MNCs. Now the MNCs are posing the threat in every country of the world. So what was the need of the hour? That we should develop our countries, industries and firms in that manner, so that they can also produce the world class goods and world class services to compete the world market. To initiate reforms in various sectors of economy, like industrial sector, financial sector, foreign exchange, foreign trade, etc. See, all these reforms, they were not related to a single sector. They were related to the many sectors. So the reform have affected the foreign sector because of the liberalization, less tariffs and less quotas, means lessening the foreign trade barriers or obstacles. Then in industrial sector, the reforms have given much flexibility, much freedom toward control and management, and privatization also help in this. So to initiate reforms in the various sectors of the economy, like industrial sector, financial sector, in the financial sector also, bank reforms were there, tax related reforms were there, we will discuss in detail. Okay, and lastly, to strengthen the financial position and accelerate the economic growth. It is the most important to accelerate the economic growth of an economy.